So it occurred to me while I was looking back at the logs that I left on Epstein's Island that I had left a great deal of context out of Juana Man 2019, September 11th. The video is a tragedy in its own part. I didn't think I did that joke already. I'm really bad at this. You know, the issue with comedy is that you have to keep doing it. And a nigga's been stressed lately. I'm gonna use a comedy shortcut here, actually. But I learned how to reclaim this footage. Let's look inside my retard box. You thought I was playing with you, but I was gonna show it to you, but that was just like I'm gonna show it to you now. Addendum: Juana Man footage, part 1, rated R. So, I was coming back from the movie theaters the other day, and I had just seen Juana Man. And if you haven't seen Juana Man, spoilers. But there's this one scene in particular that really just stood out to me. It was the climax of the film in which Juana Man finds herself in the women's locker room while the team is undressing. She then proceeds to
savagely beat her ball back in front of them.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that. If it still didn't make any sense, that's neither of our faults. You probably don't have the same experiences as me, and you couldn't translate any meaning into that. You might enjoy Krav Maga, or beatboxing. And that's fine. I could tell you right now that I saw a few videos of men being killed in the street and wondered if the man that invented Krav Maga would have gone down a different path if his name wasn't Stephanie. He was probably bullied quite a bit. And that is sad. I wish I could just hold him and tell him everything would be alright, but that doesn't justify making this very deadly martial arts school to be used by the Israeli military for war crimes and human rights violations. But we're not gonna cast blame on anyone. I just want to prevent this from happening ever again. So I ask you, if you're with child, or even thinking about having children, or maybe a dog, or a spider, that you name it a single syllable word. If I can give you a recommendation, or maybe suggestions that would be nice for your dog, spider, or child. Spray is a nice name, or Klug. Or even Jan. That is if you're feeling spicy. And the funny thing is,
my dog Jan.
Do you want to know what my name is?
If you were wondering,
it showed up one day and it never left. It's Tan. And people called me girl's name. But you don't see me going out, bulldozing Palestinian homes for, settlement expansion or for fun. Or for sexual pleasure. I just don't do that. And sorry I went off on this tangential. I'm really proud of that joke because, it's Tan's me and it's like a tangential because it's me going off topic, but my name's also Tan, so it's like an original. Like, sadly, or fortunately, we're not here to talk about foreign policy. You can listen to my takes on those in previous videos that I've made. Juana Man is one of them. Right now, I want to show you things that are in my room. Rewind it, you fucking retard. No, just fucking freeze frame it. Right there. Stop. Jesus. This one says A Taste of Europe. If you've ever been to Europe, you'll know that it's a very terrible place, and you should never go there. because I've been there. And not because I've been there, but it's because it's a terrible place. But yes, when you enter Europe, London, you will be asked to carry a 40 kilogram rock, or about 600 McChickens, by the constable. Yeah, this is just a mark that you're a foreigner in their land. We had buried our crosses and made our trek through the morass, lived as the savages did, and ate and vomited their rat and fungus-based cuisines, as they did. We had watched sacrificed children be pulled into the poisonous boiling rivers by seven-legged creatures. They resembled cicadas with the legs of goats and the faces of humans. Lost men that we had seen before. We fell asleep and woke up to nothing but the great darkness above and witnessed the land birth a nightmare. The place is absent of any humanity. This is an excerpt from a book that I am not writing and doesn't even exist. Niggas in Paris. None of that actually happened. The actual trip was just an uneventful, boring, and hot ordeal where I carried quite a bit of baggage. Emotional and physical. Let's just stop it right there. And Europe left a bad taste in my mouth, which is why the plaque hangs up there on the wall today. I realize the comforts of my room should be appreciated for what they are. I had taken this place for granted. I don't think I show my room enough reverence, so I started decorating it and cleaning it. You know, it used to look a lot like Albania. Barren, with a bunch of Albanians in it. It didn't feel good to have Europe right there staring at me, filling my ashtrays with Marlboros. So, I respected my room more than I did Europe, and I did the reasonable thing and the logical thing anyone does is exterminate all the Albanians in it. And then start cleaning it and decorating it, obviously. I guess I should ask about you. Have you hung up anything on your wall today? Or do you even have anything up there, you fucking loop? Not to force you or anything. Your desktop wallpaper might be customized. And that's good enough. It's a start. Come to think of it, your bumper sticker may read, "Proud Gulf War Veteran." And good job on that part. Good job. Well done indeed. You won a war. I think. I'm not sure. I'll have to look at the Wikipedia page. But we know those are biased. I think it's important to share anything that you found meaning in. It helps you connect to others. And these experiences, if strong enough, translate into something meaningful. Meaningful to the person that you're sharing it with. And if they can glean just a little bit from this, gain a little bit of inspiration, those bonds between you and them will be so much stronger. You have a good night. Or don't, I don't really care. Hello, if you're still watching this, you found the secret ending. They call me Gaseous Clay. Shouts off if you know where that's from. But I do this regardless if anyone watches it or not, because it's therapeutic and that's a good way to just unwind and flex some creativity. But If you are watching this, yes, I am. I'm having a good time right now. Sometimes I have bad times, and this helps quite a bit. And that's pretty much all I wanted to say. I understand that you could be spending your time or money on Old Navy cash and Lysol, or funny sayings that go on your wall, like I do. But I do appreciate it if you're watching. Thank you. Thank you so much.